What's going on, guys? Holy crap, we got our first super chat. Lightbulb coming in strong with the $5. Thanks, buddy. That's for the boats? Alright. What's up, James? I don't know how my wife's gonna feel about that, my bub. So what's going on, guys? How's everybody doing today? What's up, John? Fourth went good. Just, you know, chilled out. Ordered some stuff and things. That's about it. Real simple. Hello, D-Tech, how you doing, buddy? What's up, Sergi? What's up, Ray? What's up, Scam Hunter? I never see you here, man. What's up, J3? Dude, that's what I'm doing, Death of Silence. I'm just chilling, man. I've got me a nice cold one here. So cheers to all you guys out there. What's up, Frank Holland? How's your farm treating you lately, man? You get everything situated and everything up and running? I don't see your videos asking for help no more, so I think you got it pretty good now, right? What? Leon, you crazy. What's up, Shepard? Sean, how's it going? Dude, the tent is now, it is performing how is it is supposed to be performing. That new fan was definitely the way to go. What's up, Chaos? What's up, Nick? The new fan that I got from VivoSun definitely was needed. I'll go ahead and switch over here to the SimpleMiner dashboard for you guys. So, you can see the temps here. We got some 50s in there. On the 560 rig, it's like all 50s. Except for two or three, four. Same with the 570 rig. In the 50s, it's actually low 50s. And then on the second 570 rig. And then the 580 rig. So, everything's running awesome with that new fan. Plus, I got a fan coming in tomorrow. You guys will see it. So. Yeah, I'm gonna have to fix it, Ryo. No, I haven't got the second fan yet, Leon. Thank you. Yeah, there was some weather passing across, man. My family's actually up in Tennessee right now. What's going on, Kali? Yeah, we're starting to see the normal crew here in the live chat. I know we're still missing CryptoFish. I keep seeing his videos. Like, I know you guys need to go actually subscribe to CryptoFish. That's what you guys need to do. If you don't know who CryptoFish is, you need to. D-Tech, can you put me a link to CryptoFish's YouTube channel down? It was, I had three VivoSun 8-inch, just like the metal fans, and it was, they said they were supposed to get like 400, 420 CFM each, but they're not pulling that, so I went ahead and spent, you know, $80 on that 8-inch VivoSun fan and took off two, and it just... I mean, it has dramatically decreased the temperatures. Also, taken off all the rig frames. So, I just have to keep cleaning up the wire, or, you know, the cable management and stuff like that. Yeah, of course, dude, Shepard, that's exactly correct, man. My fans aren't running at 100% no more, so that's great. I knew it was you, Sean. So. But, I mean, that's the main thing, right? Like, I wanted to have it... Like, the fan that's coming in tomorrow... One, it's going to give me... an actual temperature reading on the inside of the fan. And it'll give me an alarm. Like, if it gets too hot in there. Which is something that's also nice, right? So. I'll be able to actually control the fan speed of that new fan that's coming in. The Cloudline T6. And, of course, like, whenever I get all this stuff in, I'm going to be doing a video on each thing, right? So, like, the new fan I'm getting in, I'll do the video on. I got the PCIe riser in today. I'll be doing the videos on it. I got that air duster that's coming in, that electronic air duster. I'm super stoked for it. I got the new fan for the 570. I'm going to be doing the install on that. So, I mean, there's going to be a lot of videos coming out with all the stuff that's coming in. The H110 Pro Beast TC from ASRock. That will be here this coming up Wednesday, so I can take the two 570 rigs that I have right here, these two, and actually put those onto one motherboard. So, I mean, there's going to be a lot of stuff coming out, hopefully this coming up next week, but, you know, that's the plan. Trying to get the optimal airflow, trying to get it, you know, all situated correctly. I'm even able to turn my AC up to, you know, 70, 71 now, and the temperatures still stay consistent. Hey, what's up, C. Wilson? What's going on, BitTrue? Yeah, that Cloudline T6 is supposed to pull about 40 watts or less, so... I'm curious to see what it pulls on max load on that T6 fan, so... What I did notice is that that VivoSun fan said it was supposed to operate around 42 decibels, but that's on low. But it's actually louder on its lowest setting than it is on its highest setting. So, dude, Ethereum's where it's at, man. We tried mining. You mean the Electronium fork back to Kryptonite? Yes. No, Chase. So, to achieve 1 kilohash on XMR with the 580s that I had, and I've actually been able to achieve it on a 570, one of the ASUS 570s that I had is just going bananas. But the Gaming X 580s that I had, like the 1, 0 through 5, those are the gaming, or 0, 3, 4, and then GPU 6 are the gaming x8 gig versions. If I take it from the custom BIOS mod and just one-click timing patch it, they instantly pull 1 kilohash on Monero or anything on the Kryptonite V7 algorithm or Kryptonite. Same thing with the MK2 armors. They can get like 960 if you overclock them quite a bit. And then the white MSI armor cards will get 1,000 kilohash right out of the gate. Yeah, those MK2 armors are just phenomenal cards. And they're on sale right now, so they're at a great price. Shit, there's even 560s that are on sale right now for great prices, so. Alright, so, what's going on everybody? Welcome to the Free Hash Friday live stream. We are going to be picking a random person over here on the random comment picker. I've already got the video loaded up. It's going to go through all the comments. We're going to pick somebody randomly. And that person is going to win, you know, the hash rate on Ethereum for 24 hours. So, if you are just now tuning in, we're getting ready to do the drawing. It's not going to happen right at this second, but it will be happening very, very soon. So, make sure you stay tuned. Make sure you like the video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Make sure you check out the Discord link. The moderators and the admins will be posting up the Discord and stuff like that. So, make sure you check all those things out. Matthew, they have the gigabyte. Actually, here, I'll just show you. So these were actually $129 yesterday, and then they had the $20 rebate, but they took it away. But either way, for $149 plus the $20 rebate, you get it at $129. This card performs at 14.5 on Ethereum, or around 400 to 450 plus on Kryptonite or Kryptonite V7. And then it can get, I think, around 200 souls on Equihash. So, C. Wilson, my Strix cards can actually pull 30 mega hash on Kryptonite. But like you said, they're not stable all the time. It really depends on which card you get. They're real, real picky. The music volume? So I have five of these 560 cards, so I mean, I actually have these cards. If you watch any of my previous videos, you will see that I own these cards. I did build videos on them. So Right. Let's see, where are we at? There we are. Well, the video quality is supposed to be in 1080p, so... Yeah, I hit zero blocks, man. Alright, are you guys ready to do the drawing here? I went and got another beer and I wasn't even done with my first one. I tried mine in Chloe, yes. Chaos, you got those new cards in, those Azrock cards, how are they doing? Steven, I'm not real sure how much Electronium I have, honestly, so... Alright, let's go ahead and do the drawing. And the winner of Free Hash Friday is X Nemesis Stocks. And he says, maybe this time. Well, congratulations. You are the winner of Free Hash Friday, so please, Nemesis Stocks, contact me via Discord or on Facebook. I will comment on your comment so you guys know. Make sure to get in touch with me. A little bit, Chase. Light bulb. You can't bribe it, man. That's not bad, man. That's pretty good hash rate, Chaos. But you said the temperatures were hot? So, congratulations to the winner of Free Hash Friday, Nemesis Stocks. I will comment on your comment. Make sure you hit me up on the Discord or the Facebook channel. If you do not, tomorrow at the same time, then we're going to be doing it again. So. Now, let's go back over here to the new eggs, because there are some crazy stuffs going on. Alright, so let's go to these daily deals, okay? Alright, the MSI Radeon RX 580. $279, then $259 after the $20 rebate, plus you get the Steam code. This card is phenomenal, okay? Phenomenal. Alright, I'm going to go to it. I'm going to copy and paste the link into the chat so you guys can go to it. If you guys are looking for AMD cards, this one is one for you to get, for sure. I own one, and it performs great. I can show you which card it is. So... It is GPU 5. That is the MK2 armor. It is pulling 31.45 mega hash, and it. I can actually up the clock on that quite a bit more. So. I mean, the card performs great. It's got the one click timing patch on it. You will not be disappointed with the card. It looks great. It's got a great backplate. It doesn't have the RGB for you. People who are fans of you know, not having all the lights and stuff going. So alright, some of you have been curious which board I actually run the 560 rig on. It's 12 RX 560s. This is the board that I run it on. So you might ask me, why did I pick this board up? Well, whenever I started mining back in December, throughout January and February, everything was sold out, so I had to figure out another board to pick up, and this was one of those boards. So just by changing settings, not even trying to update the BIOS, I'm able to run 12 cards off of this board, and I still haven't even used the M.2 adapters. I do use two U-bit 1-to-4 time splitters, and it worked great. It also has built-in Wi-Fi, so it's a great board. I like it. I have had no issues with it. So, Hopefully that answers some of you guys' questions. Let's see. The Corsair power supply was on sale again. I'm trying to find it. The Red Devils are on sale, $289, $269 after $20 rebate. Where is this 1,000 watt power supply? It was the RMX 1000 from Corsair again, and it was on sale. Let's see here. Let's just go down to components, go down to power supplies. And then, let's go to this. Wow. The price went back up on these. These were down to $139 and then a $20 rebate, and the prices went back up. So, what's up, Doc Pewter? The G2 is $149. Ooh, that's a steep price. $234 for the platinum. Goodness. What? I've never even heard of this brand. 1,050 watts? That don't even make sense. Alright, so they don't have the power supply that I thought that they actually had on sale. Let's check the Amazon. Corsair. 1,000 watt. Power supply. Alright, well, those people are clearly not, yeah. Well, the price obviously went back up on those. So, let's go back to the video cards, and then let's actually take a look at, not that, the desktop graphics cards. So, you can get these for $289. The Asus cards, $279. I'm telling you, you cannot beat this 580 deal right now. It's crazy. The Duke, I have one of those MSI 1070 Ti's. It works awesome. Let's see what else we got here. 1050 Ti Superclocked, $20 off promo code. So you can get it for $279. It's not bad. $269 for the Gigabyte, right here. $250 Ti for $179. Nah, I do have one of those cards, but you did, Nick. We can last bit, yeah. It's all right, man. You're here now. There's the Azeroth card. So, Chaos, did you get the 4GB version, or did you get the 8GB version on the 570s and the 580? Because you have insight that nobody else does. So, like, as much as you can tell us about that card, it would be awesome. And what did you say your temperatures were on it? You probably said it 100 times. I don't mean to ask you again, but you know, I got to. Yeah, Azeroth actually came out with their own graphics card. It's the Azeroth Phantom line. is Phantom Gaming, actually. And then their 570s are the Gaming X, and then their 580s are Gaming X. What's up, Tiago? Same, C. Wilson. I want one to review too, man. I like the way the fan shroud looks. Like, I don't care that it doesn't have a backplate. I just like the way it looks. Dude, that's not bad. 55C at 60% fan speed. That's solid, dude. Did the stream freeze? I gotta refresh it on my end. Alright, there we go. So, they have the 1080 Duke for $539 plus $20 Steam card and $20 rebate. 1070 Ti Zotac. There's the power, there's the Red Dragon that I have. I have three of these right here, and I love them. It's like so simple of a design on the fan shroud, but it's got that little dragon on the end of it, and it's awesome. I love the card. So, I don't know why it keeps bumping down my video quality here. Let's see, the 1050 Ti from MSI has actually gone down in price a little bit, $15 rebate. The Nitro Plus 8GB, $299. That's not bad for you guys who like the Sapphire Nitro Plus. Yeah, mine of those Kryptonite coins? Is that what you're saying, Tiago? This is the card. This is the card, if you one-click BIOS, one-click timing patch it, like right whenever you BIOS mod it, this card gets 1 kilohash plus on Kryptonite or Kryptonite V7. So Monero, Bitcoin, Electronium, whatever it is. Tiago, I was too, man, but like my main thing was getting that Electronium, and then they pretty much just screwed everybody that GPU mines, so I had to cut ties for now. Unfortunately, I'm disappointed about it, but TI Gaming X, yep, there it is again. The Asus ROG Strix 570s, I have 9 of these, and I got replacement fans coming in tomorrow, and I'm so happy. I'm so happy for it. Chase, honestly, man, I'm not sure. I haven't tried Kryptonite Heavy, but I think it should perform the same, right? No. It's not that the non-MK2 sucks, Lightbub. It's just that they don't come with a backplate. The new MK2s look nice. Matthew, are you saying, like, I'm disappointed about Electronium or the fact that they went back to the ASICs? Like, I don't blame them for going back to ASICs. It's just, why did it take that long? How come, like, if they wanted the GPU miners to actually be involved in it in the first place, then how come they didn't immediately change? Like, why didn't they immediately hard fork? They waited too long, so once they actually took the ASICs off, then nobody wanted to mine it anymore because of how they dicked them over. And that's just honest. Like, if you got screwed over by a coin, then you're not going to go back and start mining it again. I agree, Tiago. $279 for the 4GB Sapphire Nitro Plus. $479 for the 1070 Ti Zotac 3 fan model. Who is it that has the 550 rig? You might be able to, Chase. I haven't actually... I think I tried it once, but I don't remember the results that I got. $1070 Ti, $499 for the gaming, $8G from MSI, $479 after the rebate, plus $20 Steam card. $259 for the ASRock Phantom Gaming X 578GB. So I think Chaos was saying these get 24 without BIOS modding. So once you actually BIOS mod these cards, they should get, what, 29, 30? $31.3, he says. So, these are the ASRock Phantom cards that came out. They look, I like the fan shroud. I mean, it's simple, but I mean, all the stats are there. 2048 stream processor, that's what you need. I'll link this down below for you guys. So you get a 10% off promo code plus a $20 rebate on these Power Color Red Dragons. So these are the 14 compute units. So I think these only go up to 896 stream processors. Some of these cards are actually able to unlock it and get 1024, but it really just depends. Well, the backplate is nice because it kind of prevents GPU sag, you know? It kind of holds it up. If you guys see me skip over something, just let me know. The 550, you can get it for $109. Well, $114 with shipping. There's the 8GB version of the 580 for $279. The Red Devil, $289, $20 rebate in Power Color. A lot of people are building rigs out of these. I'm kind of jealous. Dude, Chase, you are correct. The RGB brings your hash rate up quite a bit, man. EVGA 1080, $549 with a 650 watt gold PSU. That ain't too bad. Or you can get it for $529 after rebate for the For the Win version. You know, Chaos, I thought that the ASRock on the top of it would actually light up too. TIs for $789. I don't know. I know there's a few people that like these, but the MSI 1080 Ti that I want. See, the titaniums are still on sale, or they come with a rebate for $479. You can't beat that.
But it's no use.
I would not buy this MSI card. So, if you guys have been looking at it, don't get it. What's up, TJ? How's it going? What's up, Ozzy Bogan? I think Sergi is sending me one of these right here, so I'm pretty happy about that. There's the 570 MK2 armor. It's actually more expensive than the 580. I already saw it, Matthew. You said you'd give it to me for free. Thanks, man. We got him, Chase. You just gotta keep hassling him about it. I probably can. Well, I'm gonna try, man. Yeah, he said he was gonna pay me to take it, you know? That is not a bad deal on that Asus Strix 1080 Ti. I just, I don't have... I can't get it. The Asus Strix 1080 Ti's have the best cooling performance for open air. A 570 armor, 8 gigs, not the MK2. You're still better off buying the 580s. That's right, Ozzy, you don't discriminate. Matthew, why don't you join the Discord, dude? Yeah. Those MSI armor cards are nice, man. What's going on, Beeper? You out of nowhere just saying that. Do you like those cards? I love them. You're gonna have to let that marinate on me a little bit, Matthew. There was one of the cards that went on sale at Best Buy a while back that people were talking about and that I linked. I can't remember which one it was, but it went on like a good sale. Okay, then yeah. That was it. There's that 390 that somebody has. I want that. There you go. You get a six pack of 1080 Founders Editions for only $6,614. Hard pass. See, Power Color Red Devil RX 570 4 gigs, 10% off promo code. Plus a $20 rebate. So that's what, $25 off. So that brings it down to $225 with the $20 eBay. So you can get it for $205 or $210 with shipping. What's going on, Brett? Yeah, it looks like a nice card, man. No, Micron actually overclocks really, really well, Beeper. Which one, J3? Sergi, honestly, with rebates, I don't know. I know it offers the rebate, but I never send my rebates in. Hey, thanks, Chase, man. I appreciate it. You have a good night, too, man. Comes with the backplate. Like, these pictures never do the cards justice. Like, once you actually get them in the mail and you actually see them, man, they're so nice. Like, that's funny. Beeper, that's good, dude. If you're getting 30 and a half mega hash on those white armor cards, that's good. I've never done an armor with EVGA. I should have. I should have just called them and replaced my power supply that went out, but I just threw it away. So I wasted that. I know MSI will send you a new card if you ever have issues with it. Like, if it's under warranty, still, like, if they have, like, a 3-year or 2-year manufacturer warranty and you call them up and be like, hey, I got issues, just send it back. It should armor it with no issue. That's what I'm saying, Beeper. Like, I like the melee rebates, and it makes it sound nice, but... like, I'll send it in, and by the time it actually gets here, I've moved somewhere else and I never get it. $560 for $120. What is this thing? This card looks awesome. A Schleiser cooler? Capable of displaying 16.8 million colors via the RGB lights. This card looks insane. Millimeter fans were at almost 0 decibel. Just take a second and admire that card. Right. If it's running too cool, make sure it's actually mining. Like, if it's something that you're not used to, like, just look at it. Make sure, like, is it actually getting shares? Is it actually mining what you're talking about at mining? You know. Because sometimes I won't pay attention, and I'll look at the Simple Mining dashboard, and I'm like, oh, these cards are running cool. But then I actually hover over the hash rate, and like some of the cards won't even be mining, or like one card won't be mining. I'm like, oh, okay, that's why. Here's the Aero ITX card. I got 6 of these. Are you talking about my rig, Brett? Well, it also depends on where the cards are sitting. If they're sitting on the very outside, then it's getting all that cool air and it's being able to suck it in and actually blow it across the heatsink. So that might be where your lowest temperatures are at. You might have a pocket of hot air at one point. Alright, that song actually coughs. It wasn't me that coughed. I mean, just look at these GPUs that come from Colorful, okay? Like, these GPUs are bonanzas, man. What's up, Bob? Exactly. Transformers. I love the way this fan shroud is. I can't afford $1,500, but I love it. I swear it was the song. I swear. Okay, let me see. Alright, so we're gonna find out here if it was me or the song. I think I went too far back. Has anybody built a rig out of these cards? Did you hear it? Okay. We'll be right back. Oh, I think I went too far back. Damn it! No. What's up, JTM? Bob, I think my total wattage draw now is... somewhere probably around 4,000 watts. Maybe less. Probably a lot less than that. Probably around 3,500. Oh, I went way too far back. Electricity was 380 this month. So my rigs cost me about $230 a run. See? It wasn't me, that's the song. Damn, Brett, 12,000 watts? What are you running, like, 100 GPUs? I'm at 0.087, Sergi. So, close, but not exactly 9. See? That's not me! That's the song. Damn, Brett. Damn, Bob, really? I don't have tiered rates here. Or at least I haven't hit that point yet. Like, what do you live in? Like a 30,000 square foot house? I mean, you don't have to answer that. No. I'm talking about Brett. Shit, Sergi. I don't like it. ST4. I guess it's not here anymore. Hey, here's the fan that I got. As you can see, I purchased it. I love it.
You say you wanna try, but you never.
$0.47 kilowatt hour? Shit. What's up, Lewis? Crazy price. Let's see what Newegg's broken. Alright, there's a song I'm gonna look for since that's towards the end of the stream. Gonna look for it so you guys are not gonna hear anything. Yeah, here we go. So I was looking at the solar panels that they have at like Harbor Freight, but they're only 100 watt solar panels. You guys heard this song before? Decisions, but I want it all, so I get it all. I wanna eat the whole cake. I wanna eat the whole cake, man. I want all the money. I'm not sharing. Bitches love cake. Okay, so $6,000 for 6,600 watts. Nice, Brett. Oh, I know. Some of it has to get storage for overnight use, too. Search by highest price? Alright. I have a crypto farm in my apartment. Yeah, that's expensive. I pay 0.087 per kilowatt. Yeah, you gotta have like batteries to store it and stuff too, right? Yeah. Okay, Ryle. What the hell am I gonna do with 22 solar panels? Ah, hey, apartment complex, just let me fucking spread these across the roof. Are we back yet? Okay. Let's see here. Let's see. Come on. For some reason, the connection dropped out, but it's showing that it's connected on my end. So let's see. We're almost back? Okay, it looks like we're back. Okay. So, just following up on the Simple Mining dashboard, you can see all the temperatures here. We're running quite cool, and I'm excited about that. Tomorrow we should see lower temperatures with a new fan coming in. But DTech has linked the Discord channel down below, so make sure you guys go check that out. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you comment. I mean, obviously you are commenting here in the, you know, the chat. Thank you for all the top chat donators. It is very much appreciated. Thank you very much. And, you know, we are going to try to get in contact with the Free Hash Friday winner, and if we can, then we'll move forward with it. If not, then tomorrow we'll do the Free Hash Friday drawing again, and it will come from the Discord. So, or not the Discord, from the live chat or the Discord. Actually, you know, who knows? I can come up with whatever I want to. So, I will see you guys there. Make sure you join the Discord chat. I will be there, and I will talk to you guys then. Peace out!